Hello everyone, good morning, good afternoon, or good evening wherever you are joining us from. My name is Muhammad Azizul Hakim. You can call me Muhammad or Aziz for short. I am a Python technical writer at Embarcadero Technologies. Welcome to Python for Delphi with Python AI Library Demo Series. This is the first video of the series. In this video, we will demonstrate how well Python for Delphi will bridge the two programming language giants, Delphi and Python. Delphi will give Python great GUI capabilities, and on the other hand, show Python with its numerous data science, machine learning, or AI libraries. You can consume any data science, machine learning, or AI functionalities to your Delphi programs. The first library that we will show you is Keras. Keras is a high-level neural networks API for Python, which acts as an interface for the TensorFlow library. To give you some insights about how the performance of this demo on your system, here I share with you briefly about my working environment. For the hardware, I use a laptop with an Intel Core i5 processor, 12GB of RAM, and Intel UHD Graphics 620 for the graphic card. For the OS, I use Windows 10 Home Edition. According to my experiences, this demo also works well with lower specs. For the Python version, I use Python version 3.8, which I find as a stable version when I work with Python for Delphi and combine it with other libraries. And for the prerequisites, first, you need Python for Delphi installed on your system. For the installation guide, you can follow the YouTube video by Jim McKeith, which I also put the link on the description. Second, install the required library. If you haven't installed it, you can easily install it with this pip command. Another prerequisite is you need to put the path where the required library is installed to the system environment variables. Here are the examples of those paths, and let's get started. The credit for the code example used in this demo belongs to François Cholet, the creator of Keras and author of Deep Learning with Python. A brief information about the dataset we use here. In this tutorial, we will use the famous Kaggle's Cats versus Dogs binary classification dataset. The image dataset is around 787 megabytes, which you can download as zip raw data. You can download the data simply by running this curl command on your command prompt. Here is how the download progress would look like on your command prompt. You can also read more about this in our blog post at pythongui.org, the link in our description. Next, unzip the dataset with this command. With the ls command, now we can see that pet images folder that contains two subfolders, cat and dog. Each subfolder contains image files for each category. Let's see. This is actually a really cool dataset. It contains thousands of images of cats and dogs. A rich dataset for image processing, computer vision, or deep learning. Let's back to our slide. The following is a code example of Keras to prepare and visualize the famous Kaggle's Cats versus Dogs dataset for deep learning. Before running any code, make sure the pet images folder already in the same directory with your Python for Delphi demo01.exe file. here it is. Let's copy paste and run this code inside the lower memo of our Python for Delphi first demo GUI. And click execute script. It will take a moment to completely show the result. So let's grab our coffee. And here it is, a pretty cool image just shown up. Let's see the result. We successfully visualized the dataset, the pet images with their encodings. Cat S0 and dog S1. And another output inside the upper memo is telling us about we have deleted 0 image data. Our image dataset in total are about 23,000 pet image files that belonging to two classes, cat versus dog. We use 80% of the data as training data and the rest 20% for testing or validation. That's it. Congratulations. You are successfully empowering the Windows GUI apps with Python's Keras library. In the last slide, we compile some links for you to read further if you encounter any problems. See you in the next demo. Thanks for watching.